The race has truly begun. Just 3 days to go for the first phase of voting, and the BJP is just in time with its manifesto. The BJP's headquarters in Delhi was a packed house today, understandably so. All the party bigwigs were on the stage to release what the BJP is calling its Sankalp Patra. It's a manifesto of 75 promises, and here is the crux. On national security, the BJP promised to speed up defense purchases, zero tolerance on terrorism, they said, a free hand to security forces. On the citizenship bill, the BJP continues to stand by it. Not only does the party want to complete this process in Assam, it has promised to extend the national register of citizens across the country. Now for the constants. Two promises that the BJP has been making since the time of the Jansangh. Scrapping Article 370 that gives a special status to Jammu and Kashmir, and Article 35A, a law that doesn't allow outsiders to own property in Jammu and Kashmir. Next comes agriculture. Besides giving 6,000 rupees to farmers every year, the BJP promises to issue interest-free credit card loans and short-term agricultural loans up to 1 lakh at 0% interest rate. And finally, the issue of the Ram Temple. Once again, the party has promised to build the Ram Temple in Ayodhya.
आजादी के 100 साल हो तब देश डेवलपिंग कंट्री से डेवलप कंट्री की ऊंचाई को कैसे पार करें? और ऐसी बहुत सी बातें कह सकते हैं हम, लेकिन मैं 2047 की ओर नहीं ले जा रहा हूं आपको, लेकिन 2047 का जो मजबूत फाउंडेशन है 2019 से 24 में रखना होगा। 75 वर्ष, 75 लक्ष्य ये हमने तय किए हैं, 75 निश्चित कदम हमने तय किए हैं, ये अपने आप में टाइम बाउंड, वेल डिफाइंड, शायद ही कोई घोषणा पत्र में या संकल्प पत्र में आप पहली बार देख पाते होंगे।
Now here's the interesting thing. This is not a five-year manifesto. The BJP has laid out the roadmap till 2047. That's taking optimism to a whole new level. What about the Congress? Now that we know what both parties are offering, let's compare the two manifestos. We identified six promises that may prove to be clinchers, six issues that will guide the choice of the voter this time around. First up is national security after the Balakot attack. It is on the priority list of both the Congress and the BJP. As we told you, the BJP has promised to modernize India's defense forces. They want to make India one of the most powerful defense forces in the world. The Congress promises the same, but they also want to re-establish the National Security Advisory Board. Next is the issue of poverty. The BJP wants to bring down the number of poor to single digits in the next 5 years. The Congress promises Nyay, a direct cash transfer of 72,000 rupees every year to India's poorest 20%. Issue number three is farmers, the agrarian distress. What is either side offering? The BJP once again promises to double the income of farmers by 2022. The Congress wants to go easy on loan defaults. Right now it is a criminal offence. The Congress says they'll make it a civil offence. Next on our list is employment, jobs. The BJP says it will extend support to what it calls 22 major champion sectors of the Indian economy. The Congress promises to fill 4 lakh government job vacancies within a year of forming a government. Then comes education. The BJP promises to bring all secondary schools under Operation Digital Board. This is an attempt to leverage technology to boost the quality of education. The Congress wants to spend 6% of the annual budget on this sector. And finally, the contentious National Register of Citizens. The BJP wants to implement this across the country. The Congress wants to make changes to the existing provisions. So there you have it, the best of both the manifestos, the best of the worst. Of course, a political war over manifestos is bound to happen. In fact, it's already begun. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley says the BJP's manifesto is a nationalist one.
This manifesto, in a season of manifestos, is not prepared with a tukade-tukade mindset. It's not even prepared with an Ivy League mindset.